Okay, so now we actually might have enough.
Yeah,
right?
No, might.
All right, so we go.
Everything is. You know why? Because we play that land. That is exactly 8 mana.
Oh yeah.
Oh nice. Sick. Nice. See, we don't have to tap any creatures. Excellent. All right, and even if this doesn't work, then we've got our second main phase to still cast things if we want to. All right. Yeah, bam. Yay! Got him. Easy.
Yay!
Easy. First try, guys. Wow, we won our first game that we've played today. It's fantastic. Focus up, nerds. It's time to enter the arena. With me, Riley Knight, and joining me this week in every week, the Mythic Championship winner, Toral Tuffelsever, and the Mythic Champion.
What?
And also joining us, I'm very happy to introduce, once again, special guest, Jamin Kalf.
Special guest?
I'm trying to big you up, man. I'm trying to big you up.
I think another podcast already has that stance.
That's what I was thinking, right? The Bash Brothers, they have like Brian Brown-Doohan as the special guest to try to make him, you know, sort of give him that extra sort of lift he needs, right? And Jamin, I'm trying to do the same with you, mate.
By the way, on the Mythic Championship, I formally handed Brad Nelson and our lawyer's letters, right? So.
Oh, good. Yeah.
Mm-hmm. Yeah, nice.
What was he doing again?
No, all of them, like they just besmirched.
Yeah.
our whole brand, and yeah. We couldn't take
it. And we can't take that, no, of course. We've got very fragile.
But, yeah, but then, like they actually said they don't have the money to fight it because of a medium lawyer. But then Brad got, like, second in the tournament, I think we... Nah, it's a bit more complicated.
Yeah, maybe we should look at withdrawing that case, but no, that's right. Our fragile egos can't stand any kind of criticism, and that's why, you know, we never read the comments. anyway, we're taking a break from Santa this week. We're going to get it done with Historic. We've played a little bit of Historic in the past. We played a bit of Treasure Hunt. We played some Hitogutsu Second Right. We played some...
Yay!
What was the stupid life gain card that I kept drawing? Soul Warden or whatever it was. This week... Elvish Visionary, Imperious Perfect. They're going to get it done for us in Historic. And we've got a couple of other sweet Blasts from the Past. Of course, Llanowar Elves, that's obviously in there. Beast Whisperer as well is legal in Standard, which no one knows. I mean, it's a card that everyone's forgotten about, but it's a perfect Elf Ball card here.
The card was very fringe playable in the green-black decks at some point.
Yeah,
right?
Yeah, but it hasn't really.
Like, very very long ago.
Yeah. Yeah. A very long fringe. There was, you know, it's like the emo haircut that you had in 2002. It's a very long fringe, and it was from a long time ago, this Beast Whisperer
wow.
here.
Okay.
But we have mucked around with Leyland of Abundance in the past. It didn't go well, but we're hoping
it went horrible.
It went very badly. But
we played Simic Ascendancy. That was fine, wasn't it?
I think we played it in another list where it was just Mana Dorks and this one, and it just really, it was a real stinker.
It was terrible.
It was very bad.
I remember it being quite strong.
No.
All right. Well, no, I'm jumping on board this train. Remember last time we played Line of Abundance? Obviously, we knocked it out of the park. It was an incredible...
All-star.
It was so good. I mean, obviously, this card banned Pioneer. It's that powerful. Yeah. So this week, we're going to get it done here with just a bunch of Mana Dorks, drawing extra cards with these ones. And then, of course, the... Budget mode, Crater Hoof Behemoth to close things out here.
I mean, not even budget mode. Crater Hoof Behemoth is just has not arrived on MTG Arena.
No, it's not. So this is the best we can do, and it is. I guess it is the budget mode version of it. Because would you believe, my friends? Would you believe the price of a card like Crater Hoof Behemoth? I've seen it listed upwards of $2,000, which is just ridiculous. But I'll tell you where you can buy it for a reasonable price, and that is channelfireball.com, my friends. 40 smackaroos for a Crater Hoof Behemoth on a fair price. I will say this, at time of recording, if something has happened and Crater Hoof Behemoth has just shot up in the meantime, I don't want to have that blood on my hands. But
I mean, if you don't want to settle for only having the Crater Hoof Behemoth, you can also get Spearbreaker Behemoth for only $3, Spellbreaker Behemoth, making your stuff uncounterable,
$1.
$1 for a Spellbreaker Behemoth.
So
that was an intro pack rare.
You can get behemoths of all kinds. No matter your price range, my friends, you'll find a behemoth to suit you. A channel fireballer. What's it going to take for me to get you out of here with this behemoth today? Is that it? Are those the only behemoths?
No, there are fungal behemoths, colonial behemoths, borderland behemoths, warm fang behemoths, so lift just... runner behemoths, borderland behemoths, behemoths, behemoth, sledge, woodborne behemoths,
land. He has a big brain.
Herald, you can stop. James also.
Isn't it one of, behemoths. I wish it was one of the things button. That when there's like an outro and he's still going?
Yeah, yeah. We need the.
I actually waited for you guys to be like, "All right, let's head into the game." Just you know, while I do that.
No, because I wanted to point out a little artifact, a very interesting artifact of the German accent. Germans have a real trouble with the sound.
It's tough.
It's really tough.
Pronouncing an S after the TH is.
So if you want to have a good time, there are two ways you can have a good time on this earth, my friends. One of them is buying and selling your cards on channelfiber.com. The other one is asking a German native speaker with a strong accent to say the word clothes.
Oh, it's terrible.
It's very
hard. Have to do that now, right?
Go on, give us it. Although you guys are both pretty. You guys also, you know.
We both will be very funny and it won't be clothes.
All right. Focus up, nerds. It's coming. It's coming.
Is that tasty?
Pipes are right. Nice and moist here.
Clothes.
That's very good. That's high tier. So a German who is talking like this, having a very strong accent like that, they will always clothes.
Yeah, clothes.
Clothes. The clothes, exactly. Although it runs both ways, a sound that I have a lot of trouble with is the h sound, so like the ch sound, into the st sound. Sht. So, for example, there's one of the big shopping streets in Berlin is a street that was named after Frederick. So in German, it's Friedrichstrasse, and I can't say it.
Tough.
It's really tough. Friedrichstrasse. I sound like an idiot.
So, right, Toffel, you have to join in on the fun, Toffel. Come on.
I've got one more bit of fun, but I'll go after Toffel.
Riley should have played the perfect. That is my final fun.
You think so?
Yeah.
Don't we just want as much mana as possible?
Yeah, but you can also make next turn tokens and then make much... Like, more tokens is better the earlier.
Okay.
All right.
1,000 pardons.
Okay.
All right. Thank you for that little fun observation even, there.
If it even tells you, like, it's the perfect card.
Yeah. All right.
Yeah, let's play that one.
The perfect card?
The Beast Whisperer. Please.
All right.
So is he actually like whispering to beasts, or is he just whispering beasts?
Beast.
The tiny snail speaks louder to me than all the festival crowds on Tin Street. That doesn't clarify. I think it's just an elf who's going around going beast. One final little bit of fun you can have if you want to torment a... This is a two-for-one here. If you want to torment a German with another word that's difficult for them to say in English, it's the word squirrel.
Squirrel.
Because if they... Again, if they have a thick accent, they'll be saying squirrel.
Squirrel.
Squirrel. Yeah. All right, what do you want to do this turn?
Let's start with the cheap elf.
Also, like, Germans generally have a really tough time with Vs and... W's, isn't it? They're switching that around because they're
so they're saying, I am very aware, like very aware of this, like that.
Yeah.
Paradise Druid.
I think we want to cast this.
Why?
And get a guy's cradle.
Flips. Okay, sure.
Yes, no, you're thinking big. I like it.
I mean, maybe
I love how the free card, Once Upon a Time, which is literally free to cast, can pick lands or creatures, but the 3 mana card can only pick creatures.
Yeah.
Excuse me?
So we can attack with a Beast Whisperer.
Yeah, we can attack with both.
All right. And squirrel actually is a word that keeps on giving, but not necessarily always in English. So, James, do you want to tell us what the German word for squirrel is?
Oh, yeah, of course. Actually, I would prefer if you could tell us.
You want me to do it? I'm just going to try not to stuff it up. So the word squirrel in German is Eichhörnchen.
That was
very good.
Premium.
That Eichhörnchen. What does it mean? Right. Like, literally, what does it mean?
Oak horn.
But little oak horn, right?
Yeah.
But if you ever get your hands on a... Well, you don't have to put your hands on them, but if you ever get access to a French person, ask them to say German, squirrel in German, and it is the funniest thing.
Let's start with Paradise Druid.
Wait, what happened to our board?
We got blasted. We got blasted.
For one?
Yep.
Wow.
All right, Paradise Druid. No. I don't tap that. No, false.
The auto tapper.
Oh, fake news. All right.
Another word of this system is Streichholzschächtelchen.
Whoa. Oh, yeah. That's a premium one.
So let's cast this.
Yeah, that one and untap the cradle.
Untap the cradle. Ooh, yeah. What does that mean?
It's the box the matches come in.
Oh, a matchbox?
Yeah.
So how much mana does this make now?
Five. No, four. Four.
Four. All right. So just
we can just play druid, two more elves.
Two more druids, right? Yep.
Yeah.
Wow, we recovered.
Yeah, this is gone very well. This is proper elf ball.
I mean, yeah, next turn there's gonna be forerunners. Excuse me. There's gonna be one forerunners.
No.
They're four.
No.
Oh, they're
one,
four of them.
Two, three, four.
Oh, forerunners. Yeah, you're okay. Right. That's good. Right.
Oh, Jesus. Baby.
This turn was juicy.
Oh, baby. What a turn. Man, I gotta get it. Like, Julian Knab and all the other elf players in the world, Dana and all the rest of them, Dana Fisher, they're really onto something here.
Fun fact, I won my first PTQ with elves.
Oh, yeah?
That's cool.
Mm-hmm. When was that? Was that in, like, the PT Berlin era?
A bit later.
Okay.
A bit later. And my first pro tour I was going to was Hawaii.
Okay.
You know what's also in Hawaii?
The worlds, right?
Yeah.
Oh, I thought you were going to say elves. I was like, really? is that where they lived all this time?
And one of my... I played also a GP with elves, which was my first top 64. I'm not flexing it at all. But the very first round, I had to play against Shuhei Nakamura, which I lost. Which was kind of frightening. And then on the next round, my very first play was I played a Land of Elf. My opponent went like, Plains, path your Land of Elf.
Wow.
That's a strong play. Yeah. That's a very strong play.
You're not getting that mana.
Would you like to see another strong play?
Yeah.
Oh, that's a strong play.
Let's get the last pigs out.
Oh, that's a strong
play. It's a very strong play. We didn't even have to tap any of our creatures for this. How much damage is this?
Wait, who let the beasts out?
Who let the pigs out?
Who let the pigs out?
Oh my goodness.
Bang.
One, two, three, four, infinity.
Oh, no!
Oh, no!
What is that? We are so safe from Settle the Wreckage. Like, it's never happening, right? Yeah. Oh, and they still found a way.
All right, so now we just play Leyline and... I'm not even sure if we play the Perfect. Yeah, just play the Leyline, whatever.
Leyline, yep.
Yeah,
what
and then
just
we...
happened?
And then... We can just cast... I will cast this.
Yeah, just cast everything, honestly. Right. Like, we have enough mana for... They don't have Wrath. We have enough mana for days.
I'm not going to cast the Perfects because I can just not mana to this. Because I can just not mana to that.
Okay. Do we have a way of winning without combat damage?
I don't think we do.
No.
All right, this could be problematic then.
Well, nah, I mean, how many Roots
Don't worry about it.
I mean, they draw
Whatever
like...
could happen.
Okay, righty.
Yeah.
I think you will manage it. You have to hit spacebar until we either win or lose.
Yeah?
That's your goal for the game.
Should we just do that?
No, let's activate Leyline twice or something before that.
Right. And then it's just
why?
Just for additional power. Like, what if they kill one of our creatures?
I like then? It though. At the beginning of our turn, we just hit spacebar.
Yeah.
I like
so
that.
So now you can still activate Leyline to make it lethal and then...
They've just got back their roots now.
I'm saying we're not a favorite to win.
Now probably not, because now now they're drawing like three cards a turn.
Oh, yeah. Oh no. This
and every bad. Nexus is absolutely ridiculous.
Oh, Nexus of Fate, I forgot about that stupid card.
Alright, spacebar. The spacebar. Right.
Wait, no, they're just gonna root snare.
Yeah. Isn't that banned or is it not banned yet in Historic? I'm not sure.
Oh man. Alright. Wait, this can block now as well.
Well, yeah, it doesn't matter. It actually just...
If it blocks and kills one of our creatures, we're very
That's probably pretty good, right? All right. So just attack.
Just attack with all.
We meant that literally when we said the thing.
You're not hitting space button.
I'm not attacking with the L's, mate. I'm not attacking with
the mana. Why not?
The mana goes, because I want to use the mana.
Okay,
you can activate the ley line a billion times.
If there's damage, then our opponent is dead.
Yes, but I want to do cool stuff with mana. I want to make creatures.
What are you even doing with your mana?
I don't know where this is going. This is absolutely ridiculous.
All right. I mean, if you guys say that we're not going to win, then we're packing it up.
Okay. You know what's just happened? You're just turning on the news. Then people go like, oh, yeah, we have bad news. There's like a meteor coming down and the whole Earth is going to be destroyed in like 20 minutes. And you're like, oh, wait, let me start streaming some Dominaria drafts. Yeah,
I can't miss that. Exactly. My viewers will wonder where I've been. Exactly. Oh, mate, we're going off. This is great. Loving it.
Single card like Walking Ballistor, like anything that kills our opponent when we have mana, could have been useful, maybe. Because, like, I'm pretty sure we can just draw our entire deck, like, during this turn or the next one.
Yeah. 27 but cards.
We don't do anything with it. Actually, if we want to go out in style, we can just draw our entire deck.
Yeah, that's
I like that.
Yeah, that's much better. Yeah,
if we get there, we should do that.
Yeah, that's much better using 20 minutes of our time.
Yes.
All right.
You have just nothing that that kills, right? No,
I don't think.
No, nothing beyond, like nothing without combat damage.
All right, Itlimok.
See what else we can find here. No, Whiffski. Oh. All right.
Strong. Activate Leyline. I reckon we can activate it 3 times.
I'm gonna keep clicking buttons. I keep clicking cards until they stop blowing, basically.
Oh, okay. It was actually 4 times.
That's really so loud. No, can't do that. All right, cancel that. and then we can do it a few more times.
Oh, keep the one that that's animated.
Okay, so keep this one.
Yeah, this one.
All right. Well, if we ever get through, boys.
I mean, it's a close game.
It's very
they
close.
They have two planeswalkers.
I mean, we don't have an advantage bar, so who's favorite?
It's impossible to tell. It's impossible to tell.
Nobody knows.
Okay, this probably digs them too. I mean, how many root snares are they playing? Probably just the one, right? Just the
one. Yeah, I think it's a one-off at best. Just very situational card. It's only good when you get attacked for lethal.
And how often does that happen, really?
So, are we going for the one more thing after this game, or is that like?
Yeah, this is game one, and then the next one is just going to be game two. Oh, Crucible, Wheels of Hell, man, this deck is kind of sweet.
What do you think? I think they're dead. There's no way they have another root snare in hand. That would be ridiculously.
Well, I mean, they've only got one untapped land jam, and so what are they going to? Oh, they've got another one. Oops. They've thought of everything. Okay. Yep. We can thin our deck quite significantly.
Oh boy.
Oh boy. All right, root snare and the big whiff. Maybe they don't have it.
Maybe they don't. There is a chance.
There is a chance they don't have it. All right.
I'm in favor of drawing more cards first. Oh.
Too late. All right.
Wait, you didn't hit spacebar. Man.
Yeah, I know. It's in fact.
Oh, it was close. Oh. Nah, they almost didn't have it.
See you later. They almost didn't have it. Yeah. And those other three cards were all root snares as well. They hacked the mainframe and put 5 copies in their deck. Well, that was a very unlucky matchup.
Very unlucky.
I feel like Elf Ball is favored against every other deck in Historic except for the Turbo Fog list.
Yeah.
Well, let's see what Vladislav has to say about themselves. Oh, I don't love this hand.
It's fine, isn't it?
It's okay. It's definitely okay.
It's got kind of our two big beefy cards are both punishing us a little here.
Is there a card like Walking Ballista that deals direct damage in mono green or an artifact.
Why don't you have a look at that on your in your very big brain, Jamin?
Mm. Yeah, I am looking at that in my big brain right now.
You know what we cut? We cut the statue.
Oh!
So, as
we came into this list, so this is a list that I sort of adapted from one that I think I'd say, I can't remember I saw it. If someone sent this in, I'm sorry. I don't think it was a viewer submitted list, but it had a Godfrey statue in it, right? And I was like, yeah, that seems like a decent, just a generic, like, fat, enormous, big, top-end card to have. Toffel saw it, and he was like, ooh. He was, like, throwing up in his mouth. He was like, ugh. like that. I'm like, it's we can change it. And you know what Tuffle suggested? Ooh. He was like, we should play the Immortal Sun. I'm like, mate, we're playing Nissan. He's like, no, it's fine. I don't care. It's better to have
it's fine.
Anyway, we agreed on the Great Henge as a sort of as a little compromise here. But yeah, maybe that's why Godfarer's Gift is in there. Ah, well, it's been fun to play Magic with you, opponent.
Oh, is our opponent playing the Mizzet?
They probably are.
Are they playing Maze's End without...
The Maze's End.
Wait, why is this going? Oh, no, because they were looking at it. No, they're probably playing Field of the Dead, right? Oh, but no, you're right.
Yeah, some gate things.
But this makes me think...
They're playing the Mizzet.
They're playing five-color Niv Mizzet. Yep.
Or no.
Oh.
Oh.
Scholar of the Ages. Man, this is terrible.
People are doing good stuff in Historic. Jesus.
Well, but now we're just Nissa, right?
Yeah. Nissa. Wake up a land, which taps for 3 mana now. Oh, baby. Alright.
Tech.
What? Why do we give up our goal? What?
Why not? Like... We don't want Nissa to take damage, so we block anyway.
No, but like, if we didn't have attack, they would have clarioned, I'm pretty sure.
Nah.
No, Nissa's dead anyway. There we go. Boo. Boo, boo, boo.
Alright.
This one's also looking pretty bad, boys.
I mean... Ooh. Yes. That's what I mean.
Yep. This is going to start pooping out 2/2s, but... Is that enough? Probably not. Because they've got a 2/3 lifelink. Oh, wow, that is maximum BM. That is
the,
huge.
The straight
BM.
Up clarion that. All right, we're right back.
Right back at you.
Actually, you know what mono green card beats Fog?
Go on.
Questing Beast.
Oh.
All right.
This is.
Okay. I reckon this one's over.
Yeah, pack this one up as well. Boo. Passes the war. Yep, that'll get us.
Questing Beast.
All right. Should we make a quick change? A quick mid-video change. All right, very good.
Breaking news. Breaking deck change.
All right. Great Henge out. Questing Beast.
Questing Beast.
Do we have a copy of Questing Beast? We do not.
No.
All right. All right. Do you just want one?
You see a rare... Yes.
Just one? All right.
That card is too good.
Yeah, exactly.
You see a rare thing on Arena, boys. Riley crafting a card. Right. Riley spending a wild card.
I know. I don't. I try not to do it, but I just did it. And you know what? I stand by the decision. Anything else?
Nah.
The list is actually perfect. Like, this list is now favorite against every deck in Historic.
All right.
Wait. I why aren't we playing the Garen Brickland?
I guess because of just of Nissa.
Can we play one?
We can play four if you want.
No, they don't make mana with Nissa. I guess if we untap into the side. Okay,
I'm in favor of two.
Two.
Okay.
There we go.
All right. Excuse me. Now this list is favored against every other Historic deck.
All right. So no Godfarers. We don't need the Godfarer statue.
No. That would only make matchups unfavorable.
Ah, sure. That would actually make the deck objectively worse by this point. All right.
Yeah, that's what I'm saying.
Very good. All right.
Is that what you're saying?
This is the leading edge of Historic technology here. Oh no, Madfellow. Oh dear.
Ooh.
We'll keep this. Yeah, all right, we'll keep it.
What? That's great.
We got some.
It's a Llanowar Elves away from being the nuts.
Yeah, that's what I'm. I don't know. It's fine. My reaction was unwarranted. I apologize. I withdraw.
This is
very fine. I hate people who play tap lands when they could play basics. It's the same with like all the dual land. Why do you play your tapped Woodland Cemetery turn one when you could play your forest, which you're going to play either way?
Yeah. I don't know. I guess because it tilts people like you. I'm not sure. It makes me... I know this is really stupid, but it makes me feel like I'm using my mana more efficiently because I'm not leaving a land untapped. All right. So how much mana do we have? Five.
Five. So we can do Paradise Druid plus perfect.
Alright, that seems good. Oh no, they're gaining so much life.
Oh man, our opponent's gonna gain so much life.
Oh dear.
If they play one Najani's Primate, I think we're toast.
Yeah, exactly.
No, we can just chump with Elvis Visionaries.
Oh wait.
Oh, at the beginning of your end step or any end step?
Each end step.
Oh my...
Okay, all right, that's fine.
So how many life?
Five.
Okay, so we can play two creatures.
Yeah. All right. No, we want to play more than... Oh, no, we can't play more than two creatures. That's ridiculous.
Right. But we play the originary.
So let's
yeah,
do
we,
this.
First we can... Yeah. Yeah, yeah, yeah.
Wait, it's why fine. Are we doing let's this?
Do that.
Yeah, maybe we draw an expensive creature.
Okay, yep, you're going... Yep.
Oh, no.
This is bad. All right.
Okay.
Yeah.
So we can...
Yeah, we can't use
it. Oh, we can't cast it. Yeah, perfect. Sure,
but it's fine.
Gain another stack.
Is this fine?
So,
do we want to cast the perfect
and
right?
Give them an angel?
No, we can't give them.
But we can attack with the Paradise Druid.
So we can.
Yeah.
And also, we can activate this next turn, depending on what they do.
Yeah, during their turn, but
if they only
not.
Play one creature.
Yeah, if they play one creature, we can activate.
Or three.
Yes. Yeah.
True. Yeah.
Yeah. But I think two? The chances no. of us. I think the chances of activating this are actually quite high.
No, I think two, it's, I'll say it's 50-50.
Yeah, well, of course it's obviously 50-50. It either happens or it doesn't. Oh, man, they're on that Arena Boys technology.
Victims Let's see if they play exactly two creatures. That would be...
Yeah, yeah. All right.
That's a situation you don't often have. Like, you do one thing, but only if your opponent plays one or three or more creatures.
Oh, no, okay. So, no, they've played two creatures, and...
Oh, but they will exile something, I reckon?
They will blink.
No, that, they gain three life. They gained three life, so in that case, we can also activate
So them. They played two oh, creatures, so but they're still two doing it. Oh, wow. All right. So all of our algorithmic calculation, none of it was good enough.
Well, yeah, nothing. Okay. Nothing.
We really, really need a Beast Whisperer.
How about this?
No, that's not enough.
That's not enough. They're on 40.
Oh, they're on 40. I forgot about that part. I was going to say, oh, 8 mana win the game, but no, not quite. All right. So, Leyline, perfect?
Yeah, Leyline, but don't cast Leyline with all forests, because then we don't have mana to activate the perfect during their turn. So tap like the Paradise Druid and then cast Leyline.
Why? Can we use 3 for the perfect and then... What is the problem?
I don't understand either.
Oh, never mind. Wait,
we can
just cast it in any way. It doesn't matter.
Yeah, we can just tap the creatures to.
Oh, right, because then one creature casts the perfect. I'm sorry, that was my mistake.
Yeah.
Well, of course it was yours.
It's all yours, Simon. It's all yours, mate. We don't want any. It's fine. You know, it's absolutely yours, my friend.
You don't need
it.
To say that. It's fine.
Oh man, are we getting rubber dumped again?
I mean, they are attacking us for 13 right now.
Oh, there's that pride, mate.
And they are on a bazillion life.
Oh, so we have to activate this now if we want to?
Yes.
Oh,
I think we do.
So, do we do enough damage with the Forerunners?
We'll see.
Yeah, that's all that next turn is, right? Okay, yep. Gain a bunch of life.
They also gain 6. Oh, God. Oh.
Hang on. What? Why is it asking me? Oh, because I've got mana in 4. I was like, I can't do anything. All right, yes, take 13. You go to 400 million.
I would really like to give our creatures lifelink, because at that point, we could just smash into each other the whole time.
So, we just go forest.
Activate the Garenbrig for Garenbrig. Big mana.
And then, yep, perfect. Do this.
That's too much mana, is it?
No. One too many. All right, yep, you gain a bunch of life, whatever. And then we just attack with everything and just see what happens.
5, 10, 20, 30, 40, something. Not enough.
Let's see. The chips will fall where they may.
23. It's 43 damage. It's not even enough if they don't block.
They could hit no blocks and still win. After
also, somehow
like...
that pride mate just... That was made last turn.
Yeah.
Is it 9-9?
Unbelievable. Unbelievable scenes. What did we do? What did we do to deserve such a fate, boys?
I mean, we recorded that video that one time with the life gain deck. That's what we did.
This is our comeuppance. Yeah, if you want to see a deck like this, the life gain deck popping off, go back and watch us playing. It was a couple of weeks ago, we played Treasure Hunt and Mono White Life Gain, and we had some pretty bonkers. We had some pretty bonkers games here. But Mad
I love how our opponent is trying to figure things out.
Yeah, find out the optimal blocks here.
That it doesn't even matter.
This and that.
Yep,
this.
Yep, perfect. Yep, good. All right, okay. And let's see. Get in there. Crunch those numbers. Ah, still on higher than your starting life total.
Yes. We almost got them
almost
below
20. Almost got them below 20. Oh, yeah.
Actually, we weren't dead, were we? They didn't have a flyer.
Oh, they had the.
Oh, but they gained life with the Saracen. Yeah, yeah, okay.
Yeah, yeah. They can. They can just gain life and attack with it. Yeah. Yeah. Oops.
Cool.
Cool. Cool. Cool. Cool. Boys, this is the one.
But that was a good game. I yeah, like yeah, that. Yeah.
I mean, if, you know, if anyone's like, oh no, the Arena Boys, they're definitely cherry pick. You know, they only put up their wins. We were just like, no, go and watch the Elf Ball video. We lost every single game, and it's still up there because we had a great time.
What they don't know is we're actually cherry picking. Like, those
we had to cherry pick the good losses this time.
Those were the acceptable losses.
What do you think of this hand?
Decent.
Yeah, right.
Not great, but decent.
I just want. Oh, I was going to say. Ooh,
this is much better.
Much better.
This hand got good.
Yep, all of a sudden it became insane, yeah. We didn't put Lana Whirls in the deck just, you know, not to draw it. Oh, it didn't get shocked. Ooh, I love it. So Marwyn next turn.
Robber of the Rich. Yes, Marwyn next turn.
One of Questing Beast. No, just a forest. Okay, so Marwyn... All right.
We can...
Oh, so next turn we can play
Beast Whisperer next turn and then Paradise Jewel as well.
Yeah, if Marwyn lives, which
is
what kind of mono red do?
What is this? Oh, that's a name I've not heard in a long time.
I mean, I just want to point out we are favored against every.
Yeah, that's the
except
thing.
For Fog, mono white, and mono red. All right.
Goblin Chain Whirler, Root Snare, you know, Soul Warden. These are some of the... No, but we're still favored, you know. It's still...
Oh, now I get it. Like, I actually understand everything now.
Okay.
That's how Jamin's proto decks are always favored against everything because he just never plays against any deck.
What? So, I played a reasonable deck at the last proto.
So you just... Yeah. That's
it was
true.
Only the one time that I played dinosaurs.
Oh, so you're admitting it's an unreasonable deck. All right, we're going somewhere.
We're making a little bit of progress. Yeah.
As the therapist would say, we're making progress.
We try to talk Jamin out of playing garbage decks. Hey, guys, watch this powerful play. I'm going to play a Beast Whisperer and pass.
That's extremely strong.
Play a 4-mana 2/3. Oh,
I mean, it blocks the robber.
It does block the robber. The robber shall rob no longer. What did the robber rob? Just a forest. Look at this, so rare. Well, look at this. What is this for BM? Oh, yuck. Oh, yuck.
Yes?
I mean, are we just dead again? We're playing against the luckiest opponents in the world. That's all it could be. That's all it can possibly be. We've built our deck perfectly. We're favored against the field, and apparently we're still losing all the same.
Yeah.
Whatever.
It's
I'm
weird.
Out. I'm out. Bang. Got me. All right. You know how I said this was the one?
I meant
the next one was the one.
Yeah.
Yeah. I didn't mean that one was the one. I mean this one was the one.
Oh, this one.
Sorry, I should have been more specific. I shouldn't have been so unclear about it.
That's fine.
That's all right, you know. It's been a tough day in the office for the Arena Boys. It's just been 30 minutes of us getting our face kicked in.
Actually, the day in my office hasn't been that bad. I mean,
no?
I woke up, I had breakfast.
What'd you have for breakfast?
Good recording. Just generally recording.
Is that what you had for breakfast?
I'm sorry. Yes, no, this is not good.
This is not good. No.
I get my energy out of recording.
Okay, this
a bit better.
Get rid of this.
I think the visionary.
The visionary. All right.
For breakfast, I usually have oatmeal with milk and sometimes some nuts.
Oh yeah, what kind of nuts?
As well.
Feeling fancy.
Yeah.
Walnuts and some seeds as well. Okay. Cashews.
Oh, I was okay. I was really hoping.
Yeah, you were gunning for that one.
I was really hoping that you would name a type of nut that wasn't a nut. For example, the most famous example, of course, is a peanut, which is actually a bean.
You're such a nerd, Riley. You are the biggest nerd in town.
That's such an unfair comment to make.
No, wait, is that true?
Yeah, peanuts aren't nuts. They're beans.
You're the biggest nut in here.
Oh, dear.
You know, peanuts aren't even nuts.
All right, I'm going to play this. We're taking so much damage. Oh, my goodness.
Are we losing this again? By the way, do you know the show Actually?
The which one?
The show Actually.
Oh, yeah. It's like a YouTube series, right?
Yeah, exactly.
Yeah.
It's like they have some nerdy topics and they make statements where something is wrong, and then the contestants have to correct them with actually.
I'd be the world champion at that.
Yeah, of course.
All right. Take 7. All right. Okay. This is the turn, boys. This is the turn.
And if it's not the turn, then the next game.
Exactly.
It's the next game.
All right. Let's try the visionary here first. Ooh.
We're getting somewhere somehow.
All right.
I think perfect.
We have to play the perfect, don't we?
Yeah.
Yeah. All right, that's fine. Yeah, it beefs up our team. It gives us some better blocks.
And then hopefully we can survive this turn and then.
Okay, wait. Isn't there something called beta blocker?
Oh, beta blockers, yeah.
What? We should have that as a diet thing.
There's a thing called a beta blocker.
For magic.
It's a medication. It's a what does it do?
I think it's just for
blood
general...
pressure. It's blood pressure, yeah. I think, yeah. Just general health. Just good for you. Blocks all those bad betas, you know? You don't want to let those betas in.
No, it's not like a very specific one. It's like a common thing.
Yeah. Yeah. No. Oh, yeah.
Dr. House uses it all the
it's
time.
It's not like a. Yeah. The famous documentary, Dr. House. Yeah. Oh, dear.
Yeah. Oh, we need some beta blockers.
these blockers are terrible.
Our creatures are terrible. We need some beta blockers.
Oh, dear.
We need 50 milligrams of beta blockers.
I think we need a lot more than that. Wait. Okay. I'd like to block, please. So, block the forest.
Wait, no.
Okay, way the perfect cannot die.
Okay, I tell you. Beast Restorer blocks the Spellbreaker. Yeah, and then the perfect also blocks the Spellbreaker. And the Visionary blocks the forest.
What? Why are we...
Wait. Oh, I think there are beta blockers.
I had no idea that was coming. Oh, I walked right into that one. Oh, okay. All right. All right. What are the beta blockers? Stupid idiot. Oh, you dumb idiot. What are the beta blockers?
Okay. I guess we eat the land, right?
Yeah. That's... Eat the land and then chump this, right? Oh, it's got blocks.
It tramples.
So do that.
We want to keep the perfect.
Yeah, we can't.
Yeah.
All right.
So this way we go to 1.
This way we go to 2.
We could
kill the 2-2
this way
and
we go
to
1.
No, we take 4 and 2 from the burning tree.
Oh, this is blocking 2. Oh, that's attacking 2.
Is attacking.
Yeah, all right.
Yeah, but I guess we can also kill that and go to 1. Yeah, there shouldn't be much difference.
Yeah, all right.
Yeah, okay.
Yeah, I didn't see that. Its attack was blocked by the writing, not by one of our creatures.
Wait, so why did we take damage then?
Yeah, I know. All right.
All right. Llanowar elves.
All right.
Oh.
So visionary?
Probably visionary, yeah.
Yeah.
I think perfect. Nah, it doesn't work, right?
We can cast perfect.
Now we can cast perfect. Ah, we can't play land. No, but if we cast perfect, we can't make a token. And I think we want that.
Ah.
So, yeah, sure. We do Paradise Druid.
Druid, okay. All right. Okay.
All right. One more turn, and then I think we're good.
Yeah.
Like, we're completely good. After one more turn?
We're at 1. What could possibly...
It creates it, and this... So, yeah, so this ability doesn't trigger the Beast Whisperer.
No.
But it still gives us a little 2-2. All right. Okay, let's see what they've got here. I mean, we're at the mercy of like Skarg and Hellkite, of course.
Or any burn spell. Or
anything else like that. Kral Harpoon is not going to do it.
That's fine.
Kral Harpoon is not going to do it.
I always loved the synergy between Kral Harpooner and the Riot Giving Enchantment.
Oh, yeah, the Rhythm of the Wild, yeah.
Rhythm of the Wild, yeah. Because
I always love the combination, as we say, between Kral Harpooner and Greathenge.
Because it... Ah, yes! Oh, that's cool! Because it makes it really cheap.
So what... I'll just let them attack here.
Yeah, and then before blocks...
No attacks.
No attacks.
No attacks. Okay, that's good. Okay. All right, so let's make
no attacks is one of the sweetest words ever.
Yes.
It's actually two words.
All right. What's the line here? Yeah, where do we start?
Are they dead?
No, so they have 8, infinite 10, toughness.
10, 17... Can you remove that? Yeah.
5, 10,
21, 14, 24.
Eight. No, but they have infinite blockers.
The thing is, even if they have infinite blockers, this gives everything vigilance.
Yeah, but we only have 4 attackers then. We cast Nissa. That leaves us with 3 forests, right? And we can cast something for 8. Yeah, I think we just develop.
Yeah, okay. Let's just Paradise Druid first and see what we draw.
Do you want to cast a Beast Whisperer so we start drawing more cards?
Or are we good idea.
Yeah?
Good idea. Yeah.
Are we not starting with Nissa then? Are we not casting Nissa?
Are we casting Nissa? Well, this is going to time us out. We have to do something.
Okay, right. Beast Whisperer. Just Beast Whisperer.
Like we've run out of timeouts, so...
So land... Are we going
to... Yeah, wow, we don't have timeouts. Okay, yeah, cast some creatures and do some things.
Okay, I think now we just pass. I'm going to cast... Oh, no, that's going to take us way...
Cast the Incubation Druid.
For 2 blockers?
Yeah, it's fine, isn't it?
Yeah, I think it's okay.
All right.
And then we create a token during their turn. And we discard anything, really, except the Forerunners.
All right.
Discard any Nissa of your choice.
Right. End turn, Nissa.
I would love if we lost the only game that we would have won to timeouts.
Yeah, that would be very appropriate here. Yeah. All of Toffel's amazing beta blocker joke also ate up all of our time. So, all right. So I don't think they don't have a Hellkite. That's good. No attacks. Love it.
Okay, so now we actually might have enough.
Yeah,
right?
Might.
All right, so we go.
Everything is switched. You know why? Because we play that land. That is exactly 8 mana.
Oh, yeah.
Oh, nice. Sick. Nice. Yeah, we don't have to tap any creatures. Excellent. All right, and even if this doesn't work, then we've got our second main phase to still cast things if we want to. All right. Yeah, bam. Yay! Got him. Easy.
Yay!
Easy. First try, guys. Wow, we won our first game that we've played today. It's fantastic.
100%.
Oh, actually, that brings us... That brings us to the point of the video where I ask one more.
Yes.
Okay.
Where you ask yes.
I like how it took us 40 minutes to get one win on the board.
I mean.
But you know what? The real wins were the friends we made along the way. So we're still only on one win.
That sounds very rude.
All
right.
Ready to go. All right, keep this. Old Questy B. Ready to overcome the... Oh, yes, look, just as I thought.
Ah, yes.
Just as I thought. Turbo Fog. Well.
So if it is green-blue, we save the questing beast.
That island is a very sad Turbo Fog. Like, one island, it's a Turbo Fog. I know my Turbo Fog when I see it from an island.
This looks like the kind of island that you play if you were playing Turbo Fog.
Mm-hmm. Brynborn Cutthroat, also a very classic staple there. I mean, whenever you're, like, during the turn, you just go Root Snare, and then boom.
Bop.
It's an old nemesis of ours.
Yeah.
It's mono Turbo blue. Fog? It's
but
mono
I think
blue.
We play like a good deck for it.
So what do you want to do here?
Perfect.
All right, and then the elves as well.
Yeah.
Don't we just want more mana?
No, we want tokens.
You
want
to start pooping out tokens, alright, fair enough.
Yeah.
Right. Yeah. So beating mono blue is good, can be done easily as long as the perfect thing stays around. And
okay.
You just overrun them. You just smack them.
Yeah, alright. So, Toffel, you obviously played with this card back in the day, because I've never played with this. This is the first time I've ever played with this card.
Yes.
Yeah.
That was in the deck.
So was it an absolute stone cold house back then or what?
No, you played one in case you want to court it for the anthem.
Oh, okay. All right.
You played more in the sideboard when people boarded removal.
Just a little army in a can type thing here.
Yeah. It was also very good in standard and very good in draft for that matter.
Who could have guessed?
Yeah.
Was it always an uncommon as well?
Yes.
Wow. All
right. I think it was a rare in some later set, like Eternal Mass or something, but originally it's uncommon.
What should we do here?
Do we have time for Nissa?
If Nissa gets countered, are we just completely dead?
Yeah, but are we completely dead anyway? Like, what would be the other solution? Just Questing Beast? I mean, Questing Beast is not bad, is it?
Yeah, I don't know.
Is that Riley's Choice moment?
It's Riley's Choice. Welcome to Riley's Choice.
Easy. All right, let's get Questing Beast in there, see what happens. Okay, all right. And then we'll play this.
No.
No.
Do we? Like, don't we just make a token?
Sure, all right.
I don't think mana leads us somewhere.
I think it definitely does.
Where?
Well,
like casting.
Yeah, eventually we'll draw like a... what's happening here? Oh, I'm going to... down and then
okay. That doesn't do anything.
It does.
Like, I mean, it kills the beast.
Yeah.
It trades.
Yeah,
but that's fine.
That seems fine. Yeah, that's basically just a bone splinters.
Yeah.
I think if our opponent wasn't aware of Death Touch before casting it, but was aware after casting it, that is one of the situations in Magic that are so tough because,
play it and then don't block.
Yeah, I mean,
yeah.
Is it correct then not to block once you realize it has Death Touch? Because you have maneuvered yourself into a situation that you would never be in, right?
Yeah, but yes, you should. You shouldn't block, because PV wrote an article about this. He was
you shouldn't.
Oh,
no matter what,
that's the reason.
No matter what you do, that
if you wouldn't have written that article, we should block.
Exactly. No, whatever you do, that dive down is gone. Right. It doesn't matter if you then make it. So what you should do then do is try to make as many correct decisions from then as possible.
Exactly. That's what I'm saying. And the question is, do you then block? Like, is it then that's just a tough choice because you have never made that choice before, because it's so rare that you make a mistake and then you have to
It is rare that I make a mistake.
Can we
You're right.
Tap creatures for it? No, apparently we can't.
No, we can't. No.
No, it's physically impossible.
It's actually impossible. See?
Only because... Oh, what?
See? I mean, okay. If we tap creatures, Toffel, I'm telling you, right?
Yeah.
Now, this is a little concept I want to talk to you about. It's called results-oriented thinking, and it's gonna up your game enormously if you start taking this line. Anyway.
Okay.
Easy game. Do you want to do another one? That one kind of sucked.
What do you mean, like...
Like, that win was less satisfying than a lot of our losses. Do you want to just one more?
Is that a two more then?
I guess we're just it's a one or perhaps two more.
Guys, or perhaps two more.
Oh, right.
Yeah.
I forgot about that segment.
I didn't realize
the problem
that. Go on,
we
sorry,
can't
John.
Do it via Discord.
No, we can't. No, that's gonna be a nightmare. There's gonna be latency. There's gonna be ping timeouts. There's gonna be packet loss. Oh, no. Nah, can't get in. Can't
I mean,
get well
we can
with
try
that.
It once.
I'm not.
I know that from our mail service, the packet loss.
From Pearl DHL.
Yeah.
Sure. Really?
Good. Yeah.
All right.
What? Perfect. You have a 2-mana play, a Marvin, two perfect.
Jamin.
It's not great.
Jamin.
Yeah. Oh.
Wow.
Oh dear.
Strong opinions.
Very strong. Oh, that was very good. Didn't expect that one to come out. Oh, Jamin, very good. All right, Marwyn, right?
Yeah,
yes, it's Marwyn. Marwyn. Oh, mate, very good. Oh, wow. Got us. All right. Ooh, here we go. Bad pod. Love it.
That doesn't look great.
So we can go. So
Marvin Max makes power better, right?
Yeah. So we can go Imperius Perfect into Incubation Druid.
Is Druid an elf?
Oh, can't we go? Wait, can you show me Marvin? Yeah, so we can go Imperius Perfect into Imperius Perfect. No, no, not this way, not this way, not this way. Oh, don't tap Marvin. Arena does weird things.
That's strange. No, we can't go into another Imperius Perfect.
We can. Do it, do it, do it, do it, all right, do it. All
right. Oh, because, oh, it gets +1/+1.
Boom.
Jamin.
Ding, ding, ding. Jamin is the smartest.
Very good. Love it. All right.
Well, I mean, smartest is tough. Also, we're losing Marvin now.
How? To what? Right. What possible card is there?
What possible creature could come up? Oh, actually, we might lose both. Yeah, perfect. Yeah. And then we lose Marvin.
That's sad.
That's fine.
I liked Marvin.
Yeah.
That's fine? Okay,
it's not fine. It's not fine. I'm trying to be optimistic here, mate. I'm trying to be optimistic.
That's fine, he said. Oh, cool.
All right.
No, it's fine.
It's really fine.
We have no lands, basically no board.
Yeah, no, it's fine. It's fine. Man, whose idea was it to do one or perhaps two more? We should have stuck with the win. Even though it was a garbage win, we should have stuck with it.
Jamin said that.
Oh, man. I mean, we all said it. We all said
it. So you say you didn't say one or perhaps two more.
We all
said
it.
I did say that.
We all said it.
Riley suggested it.
Lawyered.
All right. Oh, wow.
Are they getting the third?
If they get another deputy of detention, I mean, that's... All right, okay. It's one or perhaps three more, boys. It's one or perhaps three more.
That was beautiful.
That was a work of art from our opponent.
Yeah.
Oh,
okay,
my
human sir, we have to take you to custody. And you. And all of you.
Yep. Yep. It's a mass arrest. All right. Yeah. This is the one. You know how before I said there was the one, right? I was actually talking about this game.
I remember Human's Mirror where we both had like multiple deputies of detention and it was ridiculous because sometimes you needed to let triggers resolve.
Yeah.
Ugh.
Too much thinking. Too much thinking for me, mate. I just want to play green sorcery speed spells and that's it.
It was also against Pascal Maynard, so he even knew what he was doing. It wasn't like...
Oh, it just wasn't against, you know... A random dribbler.
Yourself.
A bot.
Wow. Oh, dear. All right. Come on, mate. How does it? Just keep. If it's a bad hand, it'll be fine. You'll draw the card you need. We kept a bad hand. Do you know what this video has lacked? Is turn zero ley lines. We've only had one.
Yeah, truly missed that.
Yeah. But I will say this. We haven't drawn very many. Either.
We had a game where we drew three.
But we've never had the turn one draw step of of old mate Leyline of Abundance there. Alright, away goes Nissa. It's fine.
So that makes me very anxious about our mana dorks.
Next turn just the two mana dorks, right?
I just play perfect. Like generally.
Really? No, it's definitely the mana dorks.
But what do we... No.
All right. Riley Knight's big call.
It's definitely the Mana Dorks.
Okay. You didn't play perfect.
Don't hate the approach because this way we can smack them for 8 this turn with the perfect.
So we're going all in.
What could they possibly have? Like a Kaya's Wrath?
Yeah, nothing.
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 No, they don't have anything. Zero.
Just bad cards.
Damn it. I think they have a good card.
Oh, they're... Well, hmm.
All right, whatever. All in. Get him for 4. Bang.
It'll be fine.
It'll be fine. They've only got 6 cards in hand. Okay, no Kaya's Wrath. Just a Teferi, see? Okay.
Yeah, that's basically nothing.
That's basically nothing.
I mean, a forest is also basically nothing, but...
There's a lot of nothing coming from a lot of quarters. Is that both of them attacking? Yeah, alright. That was not very clear. Okay, alright. Toffle's keeping suspiciously quiet. I think he can't decide how badly we're winning by how much we're winning.
I mean, you could actually just win by attacking with this, so I'm not... Like, the way our opponent just uses spell... Yeah. Okay. Well, that's not the worst.
But be assured, as soon as we lose, Topple will point out.
I told you.
Yeah, exactly. Yeah. Yeah.
Right. I just want. Nah, I guess that doesn't matter.
Go on.
The elf would have died.
Okay. That's the old Teferi. All right.
But that's just getting attacked right now.
Do we attack it or do we?
Yeah, we have to.
All right.
Yeah, we have to.
All right. So all attack.
Okay. Old Teftef.
Yeah, they might have a removal. I think they got they got a removal spell here. Now the tyrant's gone. Okay, it's starting to slip away from us, boys. Starting to slip away. It was looking good before, but
not gonna lie,
it is starting to slip away a little bit. Yep. Draw another card. That's fine. Wait, am I now on? Oh, because I can activate Castle Garenbrig, it doesn't auto pass.
You might want to do that.
Just add 6, you'll go. Cool. Oh, mate. Come on, mate. You're drawing 2 cards a turn. Surely you got stuff. What's our best draw here? Questy B?
Questing Beast is nice.
Great Hinge. The Forerunner?
Yeah, Forerunner would be nice.
I already cast 2 Absorbs. Oh.
Okay.
Reanimated Nissa.
Interesting.
So now, yeah, just draw Forerunner and...
Draw Forerunner and potentially win the game. Alright.
One time?
One time.
Is this the one-time moment we all waited for?
I think none of us have used our one times.
No. All right, so we'll just combine them for maximum. Them.
By our powers combined.
Three times. Oh, wait, they're still untapped.
Yeah, they don't have a counter spell.
One time.
It was close.
A Druid of the Cow, not quite a Andres Forerunners. All right, we'll give it another draw step. I can feel it.
This is miserable.
It is. Oh, mate. We were so close, though. It was such a close game.
Worry? Like, was it?
Yeah. No, it really was. Oh, man. Remember this card, guys? Remember how powerful this card was?
Yeah, it was miserable.
Wow. All right. I'm going to give it one more turn. And then that's... Oh, wow. Nah. All right. Okay.
Well, Forerunner... No, we're
narrow land short.
Yeah, now we're missing mana.
They should have made it cost 7. Thanks, Paul. Thanks, Paul Cheon. In play design, making these cards fair. Boo. Oh, land or else. Mm-hmm. That'll show them.
Good.
Oh, yeah. Well, boys. We did our best.
Whoa.
Yeah, that's... You know what? I agree, Jamie. What? That's wow. quite the assessment there. What do
he
you
just
think?
Helicoptered out of this.
he just called his private helicopter evacuated straight out of there. What do we think of this deck?
It didn't perform well.
No, I think the rest of Historic is just too powerful. Like, you have like mono red doing Torbrand, Chain Whirler things against you.
Yeah.
The control decks have like sweepers available and good counter spells.
It's one of those decks that when you win with it, it feels so powerful that you're like, oh, yeah. But the thing is, you never win by an inch with this deck. You win by like a mile because you've got multiple Beast Whisperers and you've got the Cradle of Gaia or whatever, the Gaia's Cradle, whatever it is. What is it called? Yeah. The Cradle of Itlamok? Cradle of the Sun. And you just win by so much like, yeah, this deck's unstoppable. But it actually, it's got a bunch of really pretty huge vulnerabilities and weaknesses. And I don't know. Yeah, the Historic format seems very hostile to it. Which is weird because it still has a positive matchup against every deck in the format.
I mean, even if you have a positive matchup, you can lose a lot of games in a row.
As we demonstrated. Exactly right.
In the end, it's really just variance.
Yeah, just variance. That's all. That's the only reason we lost. It's just variance. Exactly. And look, when we started, you know, using results-oriented thinking, the most powerful kind of thinking in Magic, we were winning games. So, you know. Anyway.
Well, we won all 100% of the games we won.
We won every. Actually, that's a very good point. Every single one game.
Every
we won
game we won, was we a had victory. A 100% win rate.
That's right. So that's what I'm taking away from it. Always look on the bright side of life, as Eric Idle said. Anyway, we're done. Thanks for hanging out with us. Hope you enjoyed us. Historic. Let us know what you think. Historic is kind of we're kind of peppering them in here and there as we make these videos. So if you enjoy them, please let us know. If you don't enjoy them, I mean, you can also let us know, but it's just going to kind of hurt our feelings and make us feel bad. Again, we've got very fragile egos, so just be very, very, very careful. Very careful about what you say to like that. But that's it. Thanks for hanging out with us. Any closing remarks, boys, before we sign off?
No. No.
No? Good. And Jamin's off in his helicopter, so he doesn't have anything to say.
I'm looking forward to... Like, we're throwing a historic eventually, right? Once in a while.
Once in a while, yeah. If people want more historic videos,
nice,
let us know.
But... I love it. Yeah, write in the comments.
Yeah.
Like.
Yeah, and of course, let us know the list. If you've got lists you want to send in, please do. At the Arena Boys, the DMs are open. But probably the best way to send them in, the way that you're going to guarantee they get seen is by sending them to me on Twitter via DM, is at Riley Grootower.
At Toffo MTG, well, that was not the cue, was it?
It was. I mean, just generally, we just announce all the you know, okay, Twitter handles. Yes. Go and follow Toffo
MTG.
And at Jacko Mattress
as well for him. You can see them on the screen there like that. And that's it for another week. Thanks for hanging out with us. We'll see you back here next week on Channel 5. We'll make sure to go and check out all the other stuff that's on the website, the free content, the cards, all the rest of it there like that. And we'll see you next week for more nonsense. Until then, it's time to exit the arena.
Boys!